G'day, g'day. Hey guys, I am alive, and the tournament is still running, don't worry. Due to Godwin's persistence, so he's been running the tournament, and I've been taking the back seat. So we're here at round one for the first game of the World of War tournament. And we have Buba and Arcturus, they're in Team Lobo Lobo. Arcturus in Finland, Buba somewhere in USA, I believe. And on the opposing team, the two German players, we have PutItOnThePizza, Finger Nuggets, and the Lone Bunghole. So dual Germany versus Arcturus with comms and Soviets for Buba. Buba coming in with the assault squad, lots of single SMGs. Also Arcturus coming in with his assault squad, and they're going to meet both of them with elite MG and elite marksman. Elite MG in an interesting position, standing up, firing. Now he's getting into a position of prone where he can fire quite well. And there's a lot of assault squad troops in this area. And they're now coming to the center. Maybe get a nice grenade launcher. No, it's taken out before he gets there. MG doing very well to stop the troops coming into the position. Look at it, taking out two, three guys, I think, so far. He's just gained a veterancy as well. And that assault squad's definitely been outshot in the center. As on the left-hand side, we have Finger Nuggets capping, and also Finger Nuggets capping the northern point. So from the center on the left, we've got the two flags going to PutItOnThePizza. Interesting name for a team, I might add. I don't know if there's some sort of secondary meaning to that in terms... I don't know. Let me know, young guys, if there is some sort of meaning to that. Buba and Arcturus with some assault squad guys going to meet up with the Lone Bunghole's assault squad. Wow, Panzer Shrek by 18 infantry by this early in the game. Very interesting by, especially since there are no vehicles to kill, and especially because the Panzer Grenadier, the Panzer Shrek has got a lot of penetration for nothing, paying for a lot of things he doesn't need. The Elite MG though has done very well and is doing very well in the center, but here is ambush. Arcturus looks like he's taken out quite a few of the assault squad. Actually has taken out the entire assault squad of the Lone Bunghole, waltzing in there without looking, and he's been caught with his pants down. Another reinforcement from Arcturus to the southern east, which he doesn't need, but we'll be able to easily consolidate that. And now they're going to try pushing the center. This is where the action is happening that will decide who gets to have the majority of flags. So far, 3-0. 3 to the dual German team of the PutItOnThePizza. Buba coming in with an assault squad plus change, and we'll quite easily take this off Finger Nuggets, only having three guys guarding the point. Assault squad though coming in to fight off Buba's assault squad. Let's see how he goes. A nice prone now is shooting at Buba. May do okay because the SDG-44 is better in the range. We'll slowly turn the tide in their favor. Buba trying to flank on the sides. Maybe a nice grenade from this SMG. Oh no, it's going to just fire its pepper shot and it won't do too much damage, and there he goes. It looks like the shootout may go to Germany, though the numbers are in the favor of Buba, and definitely will be in the favor of Buba. Now with the half-track call going to the left to potentially flank that assault squad. Center still, the grounds not being capped. Billy MG holding still. And let's see this half-track in action now. Had another fit of bronchitis, guys, sorry, in the last month. Probably know I get that quite often every winter. And viewers out there. And Gleason Flank has taken out quite a few guys and has secured the point for Lobo and Lobo. And on the other side, we got Lone Bunghole with the one pointer Flamingo. Interesting, but oh, Arcturus has got a Daimler, has countered it outright, has tracked and destroyed, I believe, the Flamingo. That's a one special point, but it's actually two special points. It becomes a one special point timer. Has been countered quite well. Elite MG from Lone Bunghole is going to be quite useless versus this Daimler. Nothing for the Daimler as of yet. Is that Panzer Shrek being placed somewhere else? But oh, there goes that half track. I think he's been decrewed by the MG-42. This MG-42 has been the best buyer of the game so far. 2-2-2 coming down to the center. And at the back we have a regular squad from Finger Nuggets. It's good to see a bit of a change now. First regular of the game. Daimler cam. So Arcturus, you played with Pringles in the last TV tournament, but got replaced by Achantis mid-tournament. And now he's playing more of in a casual team, not, I guess, one of the favorites of the tournament, these guys. And they are looking to be slightly struggling at the start versus this unknown team, PutItOnThePizza, which hasn't been known to the kinetic community at all. T60 is also out from Booba, and we'll counter that 2-2 outright. Yep, there he goes. 2-2 is burning. Daimler is still uncontested, strangely enough, but maybe not for long. Panzer G from the lone bunghole. MG still alive. T60 now coming to the open. Let's see that Panzer G do its work, or can that Daimler do a nice 50-50 on it? Oh no, it's getting stuck a bit, turning a bit funny. I think Arcturus knows this. He wants to get into position. Oh, it's a nice potential side. No. Now it's facing front. I'm guessing he's loading the APCR around. I can hear the shells change. Miss from the G. Arcturus. Oh, Panzerfaust takes out the Daimler from the lone bunker. Squad leader behind that. That's the... What the hell? The squad leader from the paratrooper squad. Interesting. And a T60 ducking away. Oh wow, 80 grenaded, so I didn't see that. Did quite a bit of damage, but now Panzer G is going to be uncontested as the PutItOnThePizza are capping the three flags, center and left, and also the eastern, doing quite well in fact, versus Lobo and Lobo. Booba, 80 infantry, waltzing back, no infantry support, not much coming now, but here's the charge from Booba, and Arcturus has gone another Black Watch. Elite Marksman Squad. And another 80 Infantry Squad. Interesting. And here's an Assault Squad coming to the center. Also split into two in the center as well. Looks quite strong. They look like they'll be able to hold. Elite Marksman now positioning onto the Eastern and may meet out the Anzacs from Arcturus and the Black Watch. See the UK spam coming up the field, a lot of specials at once. On the other end, regular squad from Finger Nuggets going to try approach Booba's assault squad. Looking quite strong at the moment, PutItOnThePizza. 14-12. Let's see how the Anzacs do. Ooh, they should do okay. Elite Marksmen are in cover, but in the engagement range, they're going to fight the Anzacs in. They're going to lose to the Owens and the Brands. Just too many of them now. And should be able to consolidate that quite easily. But the Anzacs. Easy put away, unfortunately. Panzergrens aren't good at this range of engagements. And will be routed out. Panzer G going to try support on the eastern point, but not too much infantry left to do anything. Not the greatest infantry support vehicle. HE shell doesn't do anything. Assault squad coming in. Flank or relocation of the Anzacs on the left. Nice point blank rifle shot on one of them though. Arcturus gonna try to root out the men. Grenade thrown back across the fence. And now let's see the assault squad in action. Meeting the Anzacs again. Now this time they're with some MG 42 support, or 34 support on the tank. One lone Panzer Grenadier left to guard the flank as Arcturus is still trying to route out. Wow, that was an interesting grenade. There, here's a Booba with the 18 infantry. Soviet Panzer. Not Panzer Faust, Bazooka. Bounce. Oh, bad luck. Must have hit a very, very right angle there. As it's only 50mm of armor. Panzer 18 infantry can definitely destroy that. Here comes a Firefly from Firefly from Arcturus, interesting buy so early in the game. 17-14, looks like they're putting on the pizza, are holding on. Now the flags are ticking towards the more veteran team, Lobo and Lobo. Arcturus for a shot, definitely has the range of the Jeep, one shot, takes it out. And it's flaming non-repairable. Lone bunkhole coming in with another elite marksman. And what is a lone bunghole? It's just strange names happening. Finger Nuggets, lone bunghole, PutItOnThePizza. Am I getting trolled here? It's like Bart Simpson calling the pub, Moe's Pub. And you got me, Mo, calling out some ridiculous names, which probably insults someone or me. Zetasai, 3 bar from Viva, Firefly, and looks like this side might be taken back by the jump. No, the Blackwatch Lewis gun is in the position now, firing, and lots of health loss by the Germans. You can see them struggling, fighting off these pretty militia squad also in the mix from Arcturus. It looks like they'll hold that. Center, very strong. Flak down from Figure Nuggets, and a lot of infantry in the center, a lot. That's so locked down right now. Even an MG42 covering the center as well. ZSI 3 moving to the left. Figure Nuggets with a regular squad in the open right now, not in prone. Oh, now they are. Flak from the back, supporting as well. And mate, they may take that point. Perhaps a sandbag over here, mate, may help with routing out those troops. Olicon from Arcturus as well. Excuse me. Ooh. Okay, that flamingo is repaired, so we'll definitely be able to push on the right. And Olicon now coming again. Firefly. Trying to take a shot at something, not too sure what. Oh, sorry, that flak. Oh, what the hell? I think it's going back for some reason. Another elite marksman by from the Lone Bungle and the Assault Squad. So ZSI 3 on this position. There's not too much attacking going on from the PutItOnThePizza team. Well, perhaps this is their chance over here, though. This Olicon will have something to say for that. Let's have a look at this Olicon. Take out that flamingo if it dares. Not yet. Still waiting for the horde, perhaps. The horde of looks like a horde on the map. It's just an assault squad. Oh, Olicon has revealed itself, so don't think the flamingo will be venturing any further yet. This wall proving to be the bane of the Axis Germany's existence. Held the eastern point all game and will continue to be a thorn now. Just Flamingo needs to flame this area. That will get shot by the Olicon any second now, but it's done its job. Oh, a nice explosion though. Wow, did the guy survive? There's actually a few guys survived that. Crazy Anzacs, of course, they're Anzacs. Nothing else would have survived that. And he's managed to cap the flag though. Well, maybe not. Oh, he will. He decapped it at least. But he's being killed by one of the SMGs. Olicon missed. They're missing a lot. No tanks yet from... no tank after that G-buy. Gonna be hard-pressed to find a tank to take out the Firefly as well. The Panzer H won't be able to fight it. Until pretty much the heavy tanks, which will be the Veteran Tiger, which will be out. Wow. 10 special points. Oh, the Hetzer could do it, perhaps. 10 special points at 30 minutes in. I'm not sure I'm watching Finger Nuggets. The Lone Bunghole's 8 specials too, jeez. So, not the most meta players, I guess. They're relatively newish. They're doing very well, considering they haven't spent any special points coming into this game. So that's pretty much, I think, the reason why they've gone downhill is because they haven't spent the specials. And you can see with that Arcturus, 5 specials left, 8 specials. Oh, they haven't spent much specials either. Interesting play, only Arcturus is the one that's been spending. So the winner of this doesn't have an easy road, nevertheless. They're going to play Catch My N, which is Jutska and Shota, one of the favorites. I think they are the favorites considering the practices to win this game, to win this tournament. And we should be facing them off too if we get through our round 1 and 2s in round 3. And I'm not looking forward to that. I haven't actually what the hell? Hetzer T60 taken. Finger Nuggets T60 has taken out the Hetzer. Horrible. And a Stugby from the Lone Bunghole. If he misses that, oh, it'll be funny if it takes out the Stug as well. That's definitely not going to be good for the new team. PutItOnThePizza's confidence. Struggling to attack the flanks, I suppose. They just needed some sort of tank superiority to take out those Olicons. Take out that Olicon, very nicely placed by Arcturus, very safe. Lots of buildings in cover. and there's rain in the center, and perhaps we'll enable them to go to the center. Looks like they're making a push here. Red guards from Buba. Olicon trying to get a better position. 3-pointer special. Finally, he's bought something. Paratrooper. Frosh Omega squads. Bit better in the mod. Comes with STG 44 on Panzer Shrek guys. It comes with two Panzer Shreks as well. It's still repairable, as you can see. ZSI-3 now. We'll be easily taking that out. And it has. Takes out two Panzer Grenadiers inside. The rest come out. Actually takes out three. Takes out three. And the others cower away. They can really charge out if they want to. It's a big opening. You can see there's only a few infantry. The superiority of their tier can quite easily wipe out those few guarding and even grenade that. ZSI-3, Buba a bit cautious now, running away. Though I don't think the Panzergrens are going to take advantage of that situation. Just some reason just ran into the fire of some of the riflemen of Buba's. So complete waste and a rout in the center as well. It's a complete collapse of Put It On The Pizza. And looks like Arcturus and Buba. Oh, Lobo and Lobo should get through. J-Dudes is the other member. So they might give Catch My N a good fight in round two. It should be good. So let's have a look. Let's take a look at that. But I don't think they're going to come back from this. Looks like the 5 cap is on. And once that goes, it should be 1 point every 2 seconds. And gonna be unmanageable from there. Regular squad. Guess it can come in. Excuse me. What a full regular squad just lost to a few. Few measly infantry. Looks like they hold on to that, and I don't think they're gonna be fighting. Might be giving up. Oh no! Oh wow! A Panzer Grenadier squad coming in. That's they've got to be able to take this. So other round one games to be played. There's no real potential upsets in my opinion. They should be all pretty straightforward. Round two is where we'll get some pretty cool games, I think. Then round three is definitely going to be some interesting games from there on. But yeah, obviously, because it's a seeded tournament, there's going to be the first round's going to be the high seeds versus the low seeds. It's a double limb, so the low seeds will go down and play each other in the lower bracket. And then you'll eventually get the higher seeds fight each other towards the end of the tournament, unless upsets do happen, which we do like to see, but unfortunately rarely does happen in these two. It's one of those games where the skill gap is quite high. There's only a few top teams out there, and yep, it's pretty much been that since the existence of the game. The same players, same teams, only maybe once or twice where a new player comes, but then ends up being one of those players which ends up being one of those top 1% of players that beat every other player easily. So there you go. Lobo and Lobo are through to the next round. Yeah, I was told after this game the other team forfeited the second game, so well done. They've one down to Lobo and Lobo. We'll see you in round two versus Catch My N.